Ukifanga chom na fo alti kifanga we.
What am I then saying?
Sips tea. Guys, and welcome back to MC Dash Vlogs. This is your boy MC Dash Global, aka your favorite event host, aka the Slim Bazu himself. And I'm back after getting lost for I don't know the longest time, maze. But I'm back. A big shout out to each and every person, maze. Mwenye alikuwa niuliza Dash maze, kwani video zilienda aje? Kwani squeeze ulichoshwa na sisi maze? Yeah, but welcome back to my channel. If you're new to this channel, make sure you subscribe. Subscribe, maze. Details zitakuwa zinapita hapa chini on your screen. Make sure you subscribe to this channel. Make sure also you like this video. And I'm going to give you 30 seconds to like this video. So 30 seconds. Let me keep quiet for 30 seconds for you guys to like the video. Yes guys, so I hope you've liked this video. And I know many people ask, what is MC Dash Vlogs all about? But I tell you, I will be giving you the latest in entertainment news about the world of celebrities, about soap operas, cinemas, movies and series, and also art and the music industry in general, guys. So also check out for that. And I will also be giving you news, interviews, shows, photos and videos of things that are happening around us, coming to you from the KKY town, that is Kikuyu town to the world. Kikuyu town to the world. Nah, this is tea time, guys. It's tea time. Yeah. That is some good tea there. So it's tea time, and today I want us to look at some of the news and some of the stories that have been trending right here in the 254, starting off with the meeting that was held by the Deputy President, His Excellency William Samoei Ruto. Tuliona pale alienda akahost wasanii. We saw the likes of Nadia Mukami, we saw the likes of Calligraph Jones. Tuliona mse kama Frasha hapo. Wasanii walikuwa wengi wenye walienda hiyo mkutano ya Deputy President William Ruto. And a lot was discussed and a lot is rumored out there. People say though Calligraph Jones was endorsing His Excellency William Ruto for President 2020. But Calligraph alitokea akasema maze, hizi story munasema ati mimi nilienda kuendorse Ruto, hiyo ni wo. But we are not talking about Calligraph Jones. We want to talk about Nadia Mukami. And Ruto offers musician Nadia Mukami a special deal. What is this special deal? So the Deputy President William Ruto has offered Kenyan musician Nadia Mukami a chance to lead a committee. And not just a committee, a creatives committee set to pick up an individual to join his advisory team. So kitu ya kwanza maze, Deputy President William Ruto anataka kwa committee yake advisory ikuwe na msanii. So in his meeting with stakeholders in the creative industry on Saturday, April 25th, the DP revealed that he had a plan to incorporate creative artists in entertainment into his advisory. You know, the sensation musician was selected to lead the creative working team, packed with picking the individual to represent the group at the high table. So Nadia Mukami is supposed to take the lead, and he lead ni ya kupanga hii group ya wasanii wachague mtu mmoja mwenye ataenda ku represent the artist pale kwenye high table. So speaking to journalist, Nadia Mukami manager alisema ati that the musician was poised to do a good job based on her background in finance. Tunajua maze, Nadia na finance wako aje. Yeye na manager wake anaitwa Lydia Nyakera, you know. And what is your take? Do you think Nadia Mukami will take that lead, na ata take that position very well? Checking by we have other people in the industry, you know. Judging by her age, you know, she's not that old. Tukiangalia na Calligraph wameachana na miaka, watu kama kina Frasha hapo na wasanii wengine walikuja wakaanza ku making this meeting political, but it was not political. So Nadia Mukami ndo huyo hapo akaambiwa na deputy president, wewe ndo nataka you take the lead and nyi muende mnichagulie mtu mmoja mwenye atarepresent. Anyway, but on other news, we saw comedian Njugush. And before we get to the comedian, tuliona hii story yenye ilikuwa aired pale by Citizen TV na by the journalist anaitwa Purity Mwambia. And it was dubbed Silaha Mitaani. And we saw how these forces use a sodasty of money that they hire out their guns and uniforms to be used by unlicensed citizens. Yani madhago wanaenda wanakomboa bunduki. Yani mimi najua hai nikiwa na 50k. Hai mimi pale niko na Seska. Seska maze, if I have 50 G's in my pocket, I can go get a Seska. So, we saw the DCI ilikuja hapo, tuliona man like Kinoti. Alikuja hapo akasema, you know, hizo si vitu zetu, these are not our uniforms, oh sijui blah 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 blah. And then the award winning comedian Njugush has hilariously ridiculed the Directorate of Criminal Investigations, that is the DCI, for its response to Citizens TV recent expose by the investigative journalist mekwambia anaitwa Purity Mwambia. And in Mwambia's investigative piece, yenye ilikuwa inadabiwa Silaha Mitaani, that aired on Sunday 18 April, this year is 2021, the journalist exposed how police officers had been aiding criminal activities by hiring out their firearms and uniforms to unlicensed members of the public. You know, in the report, ilikuwa imeelezwa ati maze madingo, the thugs maze hire out ammunitions, you know, the guns, the police attire, you know, ranging from 1,000 shillings to 200 G's. Yani, ukiwa na 5K uko na pistol. Imagine 5K uko na pistol. AK-47 inatoka kwanzia kitu za ukumi. Unapata ki AK-47 na kikona mabullet na unapata bulletproof. Imagine. You know, and in terms of buying, it was reported that a Seska gun is hired for cash 50,000 shillings, while an AK-47 gun for hire was valued at between 80,000 shillings and 200 G's for an AK-47. So 10K near bulletproof vest. Bulletproof vest. So me, maze, if I have 100 G's, I can have the full police attire from head to toe, yeah, and still have even a gun. You know, and Njugush alienda hapo, we saw him aki mimi kao wase, you know, and however, me I don't, I think our government is rotten. What do you think, Mr. Producer? The government, this government of Kenya is rotten. You know, so however, DCI boss Judge Kinoti shut down the allegations, saying that the seized firearms were not owned by the Kenya Police Service, and faulted the journalist for a malicious attempt to discredit the disgrace the cops have. Which, we all know these cops. Tunawajua. We all know how wanakula hongo huku kwa barabara. We know how when you are arrested, you have to sort them something so that you can be released. We see all these people, some of the people that are locked up in jail are innocent because of allegations waliekelewa na si zao, just to cover up someone else or something else they did up. So we know the Kenya Police Service iko tu na mambo yake. Even during these hard times, these times of the pandemic, there are still things that are going on that are not even good. Because you know, right now when the country is locked down and we've seen artists go insane, you know, we need our country unlocked, the entertainment industry, the tourism industry, you know. Even during these hard times, the police are still doing things that are not even inhuman. You know, so Njugush found the DCI response as an insult to Kenyans, with the police trying to clear their reputation instead of being concerned about Kenyans losing their lives and property to criminal activities. Alisema hapo, at least the guns that are killing us are not owned by the police. I feel safer for sure. So hapo unezaenda go find out more about Njugush post, uneze muangalie pale kwenye Instagram at blessed Njugush, and you can actually go and watch the video. You know, and tell me, do you think the police are really to be trusted anymore? You know, they're supposed to make us feel safe, but now they're making us even become more scared of them. You know, jumi mtaani sikudanganyi. Yo, when a police car pulls over, hey, let me tell you, you run for your life. You don't want to care if you're innocent or you're whatever. Run for your life, because these people, you never know. Utashiko hapo dakika mbili umekelewa vitu hata ujui zimetoka wapi. The next thing, you're in cell and they're asking for around 20,000 G's, 20 G's or even more, you know. So, I don't know what's your take. I don't know what's your take about these stories, you know. And comedian Jugush, akaenda kafanya maneno yake, and we love what he's doing, eh? Who doesn't love Jugush? Nani apendi Jugush? Producer upendi Jugush? Eh? Na tukienda kwa nini zako hapo umejaza Jugush pale YouTube. So going back to the story ya DP president, DP, the deputy president on scene artist, kulikuwa na now the award winning rapper anaitwa Calligraph Jones has asked the deputy president William Ruto. The deputy president William Ruto to help Kenyans to reach his boss president Uhuru Kenyatta so that they can plead with him to open up the country. And we've seen this hashtag #unlock our country has been trending for some time now. And the Miss Yogopi, you know, was responding to the second in command message telling him that the country's entertainers were just a section of the people suffering from the current lockdown. And Maze, this is so true. I am also part of the entertainment industry, you know, and it's really hard for DJs, for us MCs, for this artist to like make an income, because you know the country is so locked down. Tuliona Jelangwa kituambia tutoke Nairobi. Nairobi is under lockdown, but if you go to Eldoret, business is as usual. So tuhame Nairobi, hivyo ndo Jelangwa alituambia. Unaona? So while I appreciate your response on the issue at hand and the plight of creatives in our country, I urge you to really help us talk to His Excellency President Uhuru Kenyatta to open up the country. That is part of the message that was given to the Deputy President William Ruto by the Miss Yogopi rapper Calligraph Jones. You know, so the rapper argued that many sectors have been affected, you know, and this is true, by the current situation, which is now becoming unbearable, you know. And we are all hoping that when schools are reopened, we can actually get to the president can actually get to open our country and then see how we can actually make a bit of income, you know. So he added that Kenyans understand that the government imposed measures to curb the spread of COVID-19, but they should also do so having everyone in mind. So Calligraph Jones pleaded with William Ruto to negotiate a way in which the Kenyans can mitigate the spread of COVID-19 while at the same time protect their livelihoods and also feed themselves. You know, na tulienda hapo tukaona earlier Jones alikuwa amereach DP President Ruto na ODM leader anaitwa Raila Odinga, asking them to convince the president to reopen the country as Kenyans were suffering. So we will still stand with hashtag unlock our country, and then we can all go through to respect the measures that have been given by the Ministry of Health. So kama ni kuvaa mask, tunavaa mask. Kama ni kusanitize, tunasanitize mask. Kama ni kuangalia the number that has been given. So if the president says that for weddings you only have 30 people, just have 30 people. If barriers request 50 people, just have 50 people, and then we can all try to like bring our lives back together, yeah, without causing harm to another person, you know. So maze hapo Calligraph Jones anambia we DP ambia prezo, si atume kitu this time, mwambie tunataka kubonga na yeye. Yeah, so hashtag unlock our country, you know. And those that are saying that Calligraph Jones alienda kuendorse Ruto ni uongo. Lakini me, I don't know anything. You know, on other news, the comical that is the comical comedian. One comedian by the name of Kena, if you are a follower of Crazy Kena, you actually saw that in one of his videos, alikuwa ameficha the one and only Kalonzo Musyoka in a comical video. So yeah, tumeona mazee, but I don't like how people call him upcoming because he's not really upcoming. You know, featured politician Stephen Kalonzo Musyoka in one of his comedy skits, and Kenyans couldn't keep calm. You know, the hilarious skit uploaded on Crazy Kenna's YouTube channel was dubbed Ukipanga Form na Chopi. Ukifanga Chom na Fo. Ah, Tikifanga, where?
What am I saying?
Sipsti. Kalonzo's watermelon nature that many Kenyans make fun of, and we see Kalonzo Musyoka is one tunamuitaga melon. Inje ni wa green, ndani ni wa red, you know. So akuagi akijua ko wapi. So both Crazy Kenna and Kalonzo Musyoka, who took the character name Man Steve-O, were high school students, you know, and the two observed making naughty plans together only for Man Steve-O to throw his friend under the bus. You know, you can go and watch the video on Crazy Kenna's YouTube channel, but I just play you a segment of what the video is all about. And if you go to his Instagram, that video has gathered more than 50,000 likes, more than 50,000, and ikona over 200 views pale kwenye Instagram yake. So you can go and watch that. And several Kenyans were impressed with Kalonzo's Musyoka acting skills in the hilarious video, you know, with some commanding Kenna for scaling heights in comedy. And this is what we want to see. Do something different, because there's nothing that has not been done in this world. So when you're doing something, don't think you're the only person doing that. You know, someone else is doing it. But if you can do yours from a different scale, or if you can do yours from another level, you know, that makes your craft a bit special. So we really commend Crazy Kenna on that, and I really love watching Crazy Kenna's videos on YouTube. So you can actually go and check that out. So I'm going to read what some of the few Instagrammers had to say on the comment section. And one, @LipJKE, anasema Man Steve-O amekutoka kipetero kiyesu. Kuna mwingine alikuwa anaitwa J-Fine Mans. J-Fine anasema Man Steve-O hajai wacha hii tabia ya kupita katikati. You know, mwingine alikuwa anaitwa @DaginHomeKE anasema, oh my god, I didn't know that Man Steve-O could be this cool and a good actor too. Kuna mwingine anaitwa Kevin Kadimpo anasema, kumbe Man Steve-O is this funny, nakuinulia mkono juu. So excited about the positive reaction to his video, Crazy Kenna took to social media to reveal how humbling the opportunity was. Na alisema hapi, today I got an opportunity to do a video with His Excellency Kalonzo Musyoka, and it was a very humbling opportunity because we tuli interact vizuri na yeye. So you can actually go and watch that video on Crazy Kenna's YouTube channel. And on the other hand, Kalonzo said it was a pleasure to meet the Kenyan content creators who sat with him to discuss how they could empower more talented youths. And we're seeing artists reaching out more to politicians and them having lots of meetings to just make sure that the creatives industry is also under check. So yeah, alienda hapo akareveal that yeye alikuwa fan wa vitimbi, alikuwa fan wa Ridiculous, you know, and the Real House Helps of Kawangware. Watu wa vitimbi, I know you millennials wengine hata wajui vitimbi ni nini ba na mjui ba. Yeah, so maze hata Ridiculous, you know, some of the great talents we see like Churchill, oh wow, walitoka from e Ridiculous, akina KRM, who is the MP for Dakureti North or South, I don't know. Yeah, Kiarien huyo, you know. And that is really good because artists are getting to reach out to this artist, you know. And other news, tukona Kodhe, tukona Jelango. Na inataka kuambia Jelango alituambia kama wasani tuhame Nairobi because of the ongoing COVID-19 restrictions. And you know, Kiss 100 breakfast show host Jelango has splitted with content creators who solely rely on art as a means of income to move out on out of Nairobi into less restricted areas so they could at least land gigs and be able to put food on the table. You know, the Bonga na Jealous host took to his Twitter account earlier, akasema ati advising artists to get the COVID-19 vaccine and relocate from Nairobi. So we wende udungwe chanjo na uhame Nairobi, uende place kama LD, ULD, mazi economy yao bado inendelea, muende Kisumu, you know. And it will be more than 5 weeks before the government reopens the affected counties, as revealed by Matiang'i. So Maze, for the next 5 weeks, we cannot even like have our counties unlocked. So if you want to plead with him, if you're pleading with yourself, you can actually leave Nairobi and just go to LD. Lakini kama unapenda maisha yako, stay home. You know, he informed them that the economic situation of Nairobi residents is hard, and they may end up homeless and sleeping hungry if nothing changes, which is true. Let me tell you, this is where if you're living in a house that you're paying 100 G's per month, na kitu iende vizuri, you need to relocate and move to a house that you can pay even less, so that you can be able to use your funds vizuri. Wacha kulipa nyumba ya 100K, na kuna nyumba unaweza lipa 20K, which is less... More or less the same. So, you know, Jelango highlighted that citizens are not certain if the government will extend the curfew once May 29 arrives. You know, atujui, you know, so, kama unataka, akasema, nyinyi just form small groups, alafu muna rent bedroom moja, you know, other counties, you know, you can go to Nyeri, you can go to Kisii, you can go to Kericho, you can also go to Mombasa and Kisumu, you know. Alafu, hii inawapunguzia to cut the cost of living, you know, because these artists are living very expensive lives. So at least you can cut down. I don't see the problem of two artists staying in one house, as long as they are saving. Ni sawa, ama aje producer. Sindio? Yeah, you just go rent like a two-bedroom house, stay both of you and then share rent. That is more economical, you know. Pia liambia artist wa consider ku build new audiences. You know, you build new audiences with citizens from Nairobi. Go and build audience in Kisumu. Build audience somewhere else, you know. And don't usiogope kulipo mshahara kidogo, let me tell you. That will sustain you during these hard times. You know, if someone is telling you, come perform and I'll pay you 2 G's na umezoea kulipwa 5 G's, mazio 2 G's itakupea unga huku nayo. If someone is asking to pay you 10 G's or to pay you 50 G's and that is not what you're used to, just take the money, because that will help you sustain your life, sustain your lifestyle, you know, during this challenging time. So Jelango had some real nice advice for you right there, you know. In a come through advice after we've seen lots of cases of artists that are suffering from depression over them having been in a very bad financial state, you know. And artists wamekamu pamoja maze kusaidia wasani wenzao, you know. And also fellow citizens have also come out and helped, you know. We saw the story of Omosh Kisangla, you know. So artists together with fellow Kenyan citizens are heavily rooting for the reopening of the country, you know. And according to Jalangwa, anasema poor economic situation is affecting even the most well-established DJs and musicians in the capital city. So yeah, alifunga hapo akasema, by disclosing that DJ Cream de la Cream was one of the few entertainers who moved his operations to his rural home in Kericho as soon as COVID-19 started its toll. Yeah, we saw Cream de la Cream, yeah, alihamisha akapeleka yake nyumbani. And we also saw another news that Cream de la Cream alikuwa amepewa a six-year ban to go to the United States. Natili tuliona hiyo ban was lifted in the start of this month. So he's actually very free to go to the US and do his shows and all that. So if you did not know, alikuwa amefungwa for 6 years, Cream de la Cream, angeingia US, lakini sahi imefunguliwa, he can go. So Jelango alisema ati, dear art industry, if you fully depend on art to eat, please plan and leave Nairobi now. Get that job, apply for a pass and go. We have places open and operating in Mombasa, Kisumu, Kisii, Kericho, Malindi, or wherever. Even when established artists and DJs, nyumba zinafungwa, artists are hungry, depression is checking in, Jelango alisema hapo. So you can go and read the whole post on his Instagram that is at Jelango, and Jelango has 2.2 million followers, man. 2.2 million followers on Instagram. Mazeo ni wasi wengi. 2.2 million. See, we just make this channel and just give me 1 million subscribers, man. Yeah, 1 million subscribers. If I have 1 million subscribers and I'm broke and I tell every subscriber to just send me 1 shilling, I'm a millionaire. I'm a millionaire. Yes, so guys, so thank you for joining me, and make sure you keep it here. This is MC Dash Vlogs, and I've told you we will be giving you news from Kenya, Africa, about politics, about entertainment, about employment, about economy, about education, and anything that is disturbing us as a nation and also as a world. So until next time, make sure you subscribe to this channel, make sure you like, comment, and share this video with your friends, and I will be giving you a shout out. But let me just do a shout out on my last YouTube video. Just give me a minute to search that, and then I can do a shout out so that Msiseme Odash does not shout out people. So let me just do a shout out to the last person that commented on our video. Wow. And hope guys you're still keeping safe, you know, sanitizing, maintaining social distance, you know, and kila kitu itakuwa poa. Hey, nice. I'm going to do a shout out on our last video. That was Dash Kings Radio. Yeah, and our shout out this week goes to Alex Chege, mwenye alisema good stuff dude pale hapo. So a big shout out to Alex Chege for your comment pale. So make sure if you want to get a shout out, just go to my videos pale kwenye YouTube. That is MC Dash Vlogs. That is MC DASHVLOGS, MC Dash Vlogs. And you can also follow me on all social media platforms, on Instagram at MC Dash Global, on Twitter at The Slim Bazoo MC Dash Global. You can also find me on LinkedIn at MC Dash Global. You can also get my contacts here up chini if you want to support me in any way, financially or whatever. You can get my number on your screen right now. Alafu tupige support ya Slim Bazoo hapo, and also let's get to 500 subscribers. Maze mi hata sina pressure na nyinyi. 500 subscribers please, 500. Until next time, bye guys. MC Dash is out.